Hey, this is Dave Shepherd, and today I'd like to tell you just a little bit about Code Beats. All right, welcome to Code Beats. Today I'm going to tell you a little bit about the program that we call Code Beats. Now, you might be wondering, what is Code Beats? Well, Code Beats is very simple. It is simply a system for teaching people how to code. We use code to create hip-hop beats. Why do we do that? Well, first of all, parents look at this kind of class and they say, hey, great, you know, my kid can learn a marketable skill. Parents are always into this. They always want their kids to learn skills that maybe later on to get them jobs and get them out of the house. So the parents love it. But perhaps more importantly, the kids love it. They look at this and like they know their parents are going to make them do something, and they say, hey, this is way less boring than piano class or math class or whatever the heck else my parents are going to make me do. And so I'll go for this. And so, yeah, that's really it. We're going to learn how to code by making hip hop beats. So let's switch on over to this software, which I call the Sonic Pi. And I'm going to teach you guys in just a few short minutes the basics of how to create beats via code. All right, we're switching over to Sonic Pi. Now this that you're looking at right now is the Sonic Pi. You write your code over here. You can see I have a little code right here. You can do things like press play to hear the code. This shows the code shows the sound waves when you're actually playing the code. And that's really the basics. So imagine I wrote this code, which is very simple. This first line, I am simply playing an E-flat 5, okay? I'm playing a note called an E-flat, and it's the fifth note, fifth E on the piano, so it's the fifth octave up on the piano if you know music. Anyway, it's just a note. Let's just call it a note. Then I sleep for one. I wait for one, basically. And then I'm going to play this, which is a B-flat 5, which is a different note, and then I'm going to sleep one. And that's it. So we've written our first code right here in the Sonic Pi. Let's hear what it sounds like. All right, and again, we played the E-flat 5, we waited one, then we played the B-flat 5. Let's hear that one more time. Okay, so that's the basics. Now let's look into creating something that's a little more interesting. Let's create like a whole melody, for instance. Now this is something I created ahead of time, so you guys didn't have to see me type it all in, but this is just a simple melody with quarter notes. So just like before, we're going to play the E-flat 5, B-flat 5. We're going to play the B-flat 5 again, A-flat 5, and so on. This is just a list of notes we're going to play. You'll notice in between each note, we're waiting one. So all of these notes should kind of be spaced out with the same amount of space. Let's listen to this. All right, so it sounds pretty good. It's starting to sound like something that might be familiar to you. But what you might notice is that we are kind of putting the same amount of space between each note. And that doesn't sound very exciting. It's kind of boring. So one of the things that we do in real music, of course, is we have different amounts of space between the notes. And that kind of creates a rhythm of the notes. Now, let me show you a new file where we've done that. For instance, it's the same exact notes, but we still have one sleep between some of these notes, but then other times we have a shorter sleep, like a 0.5 sleep, which is, you know, twice as fast or half as long. And that means that our rhythm isn't just these single notes as it was before. So let's hear the difference in sleeping always one or sleeping one sometimes and sleeping 0.5 sometimes and kind of creating a more interesting rhythm. Here we go. Now, I think you could agree that's definitely more interesting, but there's something that sounds a little weird there. Let's listen to it one more time. See if you hear it. Sometimes when we play those notes, the quicker notes, you'll hear both notes at the same time because the first note hasn't finished playing yet, and that sounds a little bit weird. So let's hear that again. Right, so when you can hear both of those notes at the same time, it kind of conflicts, right? And it doesn't sound great. So there's something we can do about it. And that is we can add a parameter to our play. So here we have the exact same code, except I've added a parameter to every play command. This parameter, which is release equals 0.2, that just says instead of holding that note for one beat, we're going to hold it for just 0.2 beats. So it's going to be a lot shorter. It's going to be almost like staccato if you know music. So let's see what this sounds like with kind of staccato or shorter notes. So again, that sounds a lot better. The notes aren't hanging over on each other. And in fact, that sounds a lot more like the real song that we're building to. And so that's really it. We've gone through, you've seen how we can write code that's making music. In the real Codebeats class, you'll do this kind of thing and you'll even write over top of real hip hop beats. And it sounds really good because we're doing it all in Sonic Pi, which professional musicians actually use. With that, I'm just going to leave you guys with a little exit music. Thanks a lot for listening to my tutorial, and I hope you enjoy this beat.